Hey guys, welcome to my channel Tadkalicious. Today, let's make this delicious cheese pan pizza. As you can see, it's loaded with lots of cheese and toppings, which we all love, don't we? And the best part of making it at home is, you can put as much cheese as you want. It's very easy to make in a pan and it tastes heavenly, you guys. So let's get cooking. So let's start by making the pizza sauce. So for this I have taken 1 tablespoon of oil along with 2 tablespoons of garlic and 2 red chilies. You can also use red chili flakes instead. So now once the garlic is nice and brown, you can add a small onion chopped. It's time to add 1 cup of tomato puree. So here I have taken 2 to 3 medium-sized tomatoes and pureed them. You see the oil oozing out? That's the texture which we want. So now I'm adding 1 tablespoon each of salt, pepper, pizza seasoning, little bit of sugar and tomato ketchup, which will give this sauce really nice ketchupy flavor. After adding all the seasonings, let's just cook it for a minute or two and then we are done with the pizza sauce. Doesn't this sauce looks exactly same as what we get from outside? And believe me you guys, this tastes delicious. The best part is you can store this for a week in the fridge and it can be used in sandwiches and pastas too. Now let's make the dough. So here I'm taking 1 cup of plain flour or maida. I'm not using yeast here, instead I'm using 1/2 tablespoon of baking soda, 1/2 tablespoon of salt, 4 tablespoon of plain yogurt or curd. You need to mix it properly. You can add 2 to 3 tablespoons of water to knead the dough well. Make sure to knead a super soft dough. Once done, I'm spreading a little bit of oil on the top to avoid the dough from drying. Set aside for 30 minutes. Now let's start with the toppings. So for this I have taken 1 tablespoon of oil. In veggies I have mushroom, capsicum, tomatoes and onions. You can choose any vegetable of your choice. So one by one I'm sauteing these vegetables. You need to saute the vegetables because we are making pan pizza. If you are making this pizza in oven, you don't have to do this part because it will get cooked automatically. But when you are making a tawa pizza or a pan pizza, you need to follow this process. So now to season the veggies, I'm adding 1/2 tablespoon of salt and little bit of pizza seasoning. Don't overcook the veggies, you just need to saute it for 30 to 40 seconds and we are done. So for the pizza base, dust some plain flour on a clean board. Now using your hands, spread the dough and make it in a circular shape. Once done, prick the pizza base using a fork. This will ensure that the pizza base doesn't fluff up once you cook it. To cook the pizza base, let's grease the pan or tawa. Place the pizza base in the center and on low flame cook it for 5 minutes. You see the bubbles on the surface? This is what we want. Isn't this the perfect crust? Now lather the pizza sauce which you have already prepared and spread it evenly. Once done, now spread the mozzarella cheese or you can also use cheddar cheese. Now add the prepared toppings. Add the second layer of mozzarella cheese. You can use as much cheese as you want. I'm also adding some sweet corns. You can also add jalapenos or olives. Sprinkle some pizza seasoning on the top and we are done. Now you can close the lid and cook the pizza on low flame for around 5 to 6 minutes. So after 5 minutes you'll get this. The cheese has all melted, the flavors are infused and it doesn't stick to the pan either. So it's perfectly done. So now you can slice the pizza. For me, it gave me around 6 pieces. Look at the crust. Doesn't it look perfect? Let me show you from the bottom. It's nicely cooked. And we are done. I'm sure your family and friends are gonna love this pizza. Do try it out. Comment down below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys.